makers of the new Rinso bring you the Amos and Andy Show with their guest for tonight, Mr. John Charles Thomas. Yes, they're here again, folks. The boys we've all been waiting for, Amos and Andy. Radio wouldn't be radio without them. So isn't it grand to say welcome back, Amos and Andy? And now to our stars and their show. Here are Amos and Andy and their guest for tonight, Mr. John Charles Thomas. Well, there's always something of importance happening in Harlem. At the moment, it seems to be the singing contest, which was sponsored by the Wilson Foundation of Music to discover and develop unknown musical talent. Well, last night, Madam Queen won this contest. Now it's the following morning, and in his office, Andy is discussing the whole concert with Lightnin' and Amos.
Well, that certainly was a good singing contest they had last night, Andy.
Yeah, Amos, but you know, I done had a headache all night long after listening to them gals blast away at them songs for 3 hours.
Yeah, the fella sure do take a beating, all right. Did you hear Mrs. Van Porter sing that thing? I think they called it Brahms' Lullaby.
Yeah, I hear it.
Is little baby supposed to sleep to that kind of music?
Well, I guess they can if Brahms could. Personal, I think it'd be better for waking them up.
Well, Madam Queen certainly was great, though, wasn't she?
Yeah, but she was the only good one. I tell you, when some of them gals sing, it's even dangerous sitting in that audience. Did you see what happened when that gal last night got up there and cut loose?
What happened, Miss Andy? I left after the intermission.
Well, this gal was blasting away at Roses of Picardy. She finally come to the last note. She takes a deep breath and plants both feet solid. She lets go with this note and her bridge done flew out and bit a guy in the third row.
Yeah, but like I said, though, there wasn't any of them there that could hold a candle to Madam Queen.
Yeah, well, I gotta admit, she got a wonderful voice.
And with the first prize she won, her voice might even be better.
What was the prize, Miss Emma?
Well, the Wilson Foundation of Music awarded her 6 free lessons from Mr. John Charles Thomas.
That's good, all right. This Thomas is a singing teacher or something, ain't he?
Oh, Andy, everybody knows John Charles Thomas.
Yeah, well, you know, Amos, come in, Kingfish.
Well, hello there, boys. Say, I wonder if you two fellas would mind if I talk to Andy private, confidential, and under his hat. Besides, I don't want nobody to hear it.
Well, all right, Kingfish, we'll be running along.
Yeah, sir. We'll see you later, Miss Andy.
Okay, fellas.
Brother Andrew, I don't know whether you knows it or not, but last night in the community of Harlem was born one of the greatest female singing voices of the century.
You mean Madam Queen, huh? Yeah, she was good, all right.
And I've been thinking the thing over, and being that both me and you is great music lovers.
Oh, we is?
Oh, sure. I feel it is our duty to give that voice to the world.
Yeah, well, it's all right with me. I ain't gonna hog the thing.
Andy, it's up to me and you to go to Madam Queen and get her to sign us up as her managers. Now, that way we can arrange recitals for her, concert tours, and everything else. Mm-hmm. And all we're going to get out of it is a measly 30% of the box office receipts.
I thought we was doing this because we was music lovers.
Well, we is. But there ain't a music lover in town that makes less than 30%. That's the standard rate for music lovers. Yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
That's the spirit. Put it there, Andy. Now, look here. I'll go back to my office and draw up a contract, and tonight, me and you will go over to see Madam Queen. See you later, brother music lover.
Madam Queen, what we is telling you here is the truth, and with me and the Kingfish handling you, we'll have you giving concerts in some of the biggest cities in the country.
Yeah.
The chances is we'll have the first concert in Pittsburgh.
Oh, it sounds almost too good to be true. Boys, I'll do it.
Oh, great, Madam Queen. Now, look here. If you just sign the contract here, Madam Queen, I have to put it right there. You know, just say that we is handling you and all that stuff.
Well, I got a pen right here. This is all right with me. Now, Madam Queen. There you is.
Yeah,
well, everything is set then. Tell me, Madam Queen, how was your first lesson with Mr. Thomas?
Oh, fine. He worked with me for about an hour and a half.
Yeah, let's hear some of the stuff that he done learn you.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm supposed to do this.
Do, da, do, da, do, da, do, da, do, da. Yeah, that's pretty all right. What else he learn you?
Well, I'm supposed to do this.
Do, 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 do. Personally, Madam Queen, I think that sounds great. The only thing is, I don't know how Pittsburgh's going to feel about it.
Yeah. 3 hours of that kind of stuff could get awful monotonous.
Tell me this. When is your next lesson with Mr. Thomas?
Oh, tomorrow morning, 11.
11, huh? I just wanted to know. I tell you, Madam Queen, we'll get busy on this stuff here, and you don't have nothing to worry about.
All right, boys, and thanks for everything.
You're welcome.
Well, goodbye, Madam Queen.
Goodbye.
And we got to go down and see this, what's his name, John Charles Thomason, and we got to see him the first thing in the morning. If we ain't careful, he gonna mess up her voice.
Yeah, them is pretty dull songs he's learning her.
It ain't only that, but the way he coaching today, having to go from the lowest note to the highest note all of a sudden. You know, the human voice is just like a machine, like an automobile. Got to be took care of.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, he keep making her do that high-low stuff, she liable to burn out a baron there.
Yeah, we don't want her to strain her voice.
Oh, I tell you, Ander, if Mr. Thomas don't see eye to eye with us on this thing, I'll take Madam Queen to the finest singing teacher in town. I'll take her right to Cab Calloway.
I is getting jumpy sitting here waiting for Mr. Thomas Kingfish. You think he's going to see us soon?
Yeah, well, now, listen here. I tell you what you got to do, Ander. You can't look nervous. Now, look here. Remember, we got to make an imprint on him. Make him think that we is high-class music experts so that he'll respect what we going to tell him. Yeah, we got to look and act the part of music lovers.
Yeah, I notice you is wearing your glasses with the black ribbon hanging down there.
Yeah. I got a pane of glass missing from this one side here. Do it show?
A little, yeah.
Shows, huh?
Yeah, sure. If he say anything about it, though, just tell him that one eye needs a glass in front of it and the other eye has got to get the breeze.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I don't think that...
Mr. Thomas will see you now.
Yeah, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right this way, please.
Yeah, sir.
Oh, come in, boys.
How you do, Mr. Thomas? Yeah. Mr. Thomas, my name is Stevens, and this is Mr. Brown.
Yeah, sir. You is no doubt done heard of us. We is in the music-loving business.
Well, I'm very happy to meet both of you.
Thank you, sir. Well, Mr. Thomas, we is interested in the career of Madam Queen.
Mm-hmm. She's a very talented artist.
Yeah, sir, and I guess that you can tell by now that me and Mr. Brown knows our music. We done heard what you done learned Madam Queen in the first lesson, and to be perfectly frank with you, Mr. Thomas, we don't think you was learning her right.
Well, boys, the reason I gave her those exercises is because I found that her chest tones suffered from faulty diaphragmatic breathing. And instead of attacking a vibrato with brilliance, she had a tendency to modulate into the change of phrasing which caused her diction to become labial rather than enunciatory or forensic.
Well, now let's get back to Madam Queen singing here.
Yeah. Let's stick to the subject, Mr. Thomas.
Well, as I'm trying to point out, instead of attacking an arpeggio with brilliance and intonation, she would lapse into a glissando, which, of course, would lead to her failure to recognize the necessary crescendo for a coda.
Andy, let's sit down till this thing blows over.
Miss Thomas, how long has you been in this country?
I'm simply trying to explain the reason for instructing Madam Queen the way I did.
Well, to come straight to the point, me and Mr. Brown don't approve of the way you're doing it.
Oh, you don't, eh?
No.
Well, frankly, I think that... I don't think either one of you knows enough about music to criticize my methods.
Yeah, that's why you're wrong, Mr. Thomas. It so happens me and Mr. Brown are both musical geniuses. We have done played with Philadelphia harmonica orchestras all over the country.
Oh, really? What, now, just what instruments do you gentlemen play?
Well, tell him what instrument you play there, Andy.
Who, me?
Yes, is it the piano? There's one in the other room, and I'd like very much to hear you play it.
No, sir, no, I don't play the piano, no.
The violin?
Has you got one in the other room?
Yes, I have a violin.
I don't play it.
Well, then tell me, Mr. Brown, what is your instrument?
The cymbals. If you got a pair of them in the other room, I'd be glad to play something for you.
Oh, the cymbals, eh?
Yes.
Unfortunately, I haven't a pair of cymbals. Too bad, too, because there's nothing that thrills me more than a good cymbal solo.
Yeah, the beautiful instrument, all right. Dangerous one, though. You might get your nose caught in there, you know.
Do you still play the cymbals professionally, Mr. Brown?
No, sir. I just sit up in my room and bang away for my own amazement.
Yeah. You know, I was just thinking here, and maybe we better let Mr. Thomas work it the way he think best.
Yeah, them is my sentiments, too.
All right, Mr. Thomas, from now on, then...
Pardon, Mr. Thomas, but Madam Queen is here for her singing instruction.
Oh, sure is.
Hey, wait a minute. We don't want her to know we come up here. Is there any other way out of here?
Yes, you can go out the side door over there.
All right, so yeah, so we see you again, Mr. Thomas.
Yeah, so long, Mr. Thomas.
Oh, say, bring your cymbals up here someday and we'll have a duet. I play the bass drum.
All right, this way, Madam Queen.
Yes, come in, won't you?
Good morning, Mr. Thomas.
Good morning. Do you remember yesterday I told you I might have some good news for you?
Yes, I do.
I didn't want to mention anything about it till I was sure, but now I'm sure. The patrons of the Wilson Foundation are sponsoring a concert to be given at Carnegie Hall to be called Stars of Tomorrow. And we've decided that we would like to have you appear in that concert.
Oh, Mr. Thomas, this is the most wonderful thing that's ever happened to me.
We also plan to take the whole thing on a concert tour to the big cities in the country. How does that sound?
Oh, Mr. Thomas, I'm so excited, I don't know what to say.
You have no other commitment to stand in the way of your going on this concert tour, have you?
Not a thing, Mr. Thomas. Not a thing.
Well, it's the following day. Andy and the Kingfish are going ahead with their plans for a world concert tour for Madam Queen. Of course, they know nothing of her late commitment with Mr. John Charles Thomas. And at the moment, we find Andy in his office optimistically telling Amos of their own plans.
So you and the Kingfish really going ahead with all these concerts for Madam Queen?
Yeah, Amos, the thing is building like a snowball. We is taking her on a world tour.
What is the first stop?
Brooklyn. Then we gets on the subway and we goes due west to Jersey City. We're going to play in a car barn over there.
Oh, Andy.
Listen, Amos, this thing is going to be the biggest success that me and the Kingfish has ever had. And the fortune it's going to make for us ain't going to be nothing compared to what it's going to do for Madam Queen's career. Oh, I tell you, Amos...
Oh, Andy, I'm glad you're here. Something awful done happened.
What is it, Kingfish?
Yeah, what's wrong?
I just met Fred Gwindell on the street. He done talked to Madam Queen... And she told him that she done agreed to go on a concert tour for Mr. John Charles Thomas.
She going on a concert tour for Mr. Thomas? He can't do that to us. We got her under contract.
You said it, and we ain't going to let him get away with it.
Yeah. Now, wait a minute, fella.
Wait a minute, nothing. I got a copy of the contract with me, and Andy, me and you is going down to see Mr. Thomas right now.
Yeah, let's get going. He ain't going to ruin Madam Queen's career when she already done signed up to let us do it.
Do, 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 me, da, do, da. on the road to Mandalay, where the flying fishes
pardon
play.
Pardon me for interrupting your practicing, Mr. Thomas.
What is it, Smith?
I've got very good news for you. The Wilson Foundation called and said your Stars of Tomorrow concert at Carnegie Hall is sold out. And they're very happy that you got this Madam Queen to appear as one of your artists.
That is good news, Smith. Ha ha! Very good news. It makes me very happy. I am pleased at what you say. The best news I've had today. When the doors at Carnegie open up, they'll be sold out, so they say.
Pardon me again, Mr. Thomas.
That's quite all right, Smith. What is it you want?
Well, there are two men who insist upon seeing you, sir.
Mr. Thomas, we got to see you right away.
How do you do, boys? How do you do, boys? Make yourselves at home, a home on the range. Won't you sit down while the antelope plays?
Miss Thomas, we is here on unpleasant business.
So, pull up a seat. Take the weight off your feet.
I didn't know it was going to be this unpleasant.
Gentlemen, what is your business today?
Mr. Thomas, if you just stop singing there a second. We done hear that you were taking Madam Queen on a concert tour, and we don't believe you can do it.
And when I told them she's going on a tour, they didn't believe me.
No, sir, we don't believe you. We don't believe you. We don't believe you can do it, and we'll sue you for it.
What?
That's right. We're going to sue you. It so happened that we got a contract to take Madam Queen out on a concert tour ourselves, and you ain't going to chisel us out of it.
Well, this is news. You say you have a contract with her?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Here it is right here. Go ahead and read it yourself. It's legal. Got the seal and wax on and everything. Read it out loud.
Now, let me look at this.
Yeah, go ahead and read it.
Be it known to everybody, also to whom it may concern, and especially to anybody trying to chisel in, that I, Madam Queen, the party of the first part, and us, Andrew H. Brown and George King Fish Stevens, parties of the second part, and hereafter known as the great music lovers, do hereby agree, ipso facto.
Just right in there, yeah. That
if Madam Queen appoint the music lovers as her only managers and agents to handle her career for a measly 30%.
Yeah, give it a cut right there, yeah.
If by any chance there is any loopholes in this contract, the music lovers done reserve the right to plug them up within 10 years.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's it, Mr. Thomas. Let's see your contract.
Well, I'm frank to say that I haven't a contract with Madam Queen.
Well, in that case, Mr. Thomas, you was in the well-known position of being over the barrel behind the eight ball in the side pocket. And besides that, you ain't got a chance.
Well, I personally don't think this contract would hold up in court. But as long as she signed it, I guess that's what she wants to do. And I have no wish to stand in her way.
Yeah, well, now you is being smart about it, Mr. Thomas.
Of course, it's a great disappointment for me. I had counted on Madam Queen being on my concert tour. It would have meant a lot to her and a lot to me, too, but what must be, must be.
Well, that's how it goes, Mr. Thomas. Well, we'll be running along. You can go on with your practicing now, there.
Yeah, so long, Mr. Thomas.
So long.
On the road to Mandalay, I no longer feel so gay. I just took a terrible shellacking, the worst in many a day.
Look, Amos, it ain't no use to argue. When we showed the contract to Mr. Thomas, even he admitted it was good.
Yeah, well, I ain't arguing about the contract, Andy. It's just if Madam Queen sings at Carnegie Hall for Mr. Thomas and then go on a tour for him and with his coaching and everything, she gonna be much better off than if you managed her. Yeah, you might hurt her more than you help her.
Oh, what you talking about, Amos?
Yeah, we know what we're doing. Now, you just take it easy. You see, Amos, we already got everything lined up, ain't we, Andy?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, I got even the songs lined up that she gonna sing on the first concert. Huh? Hey, listen to this, Andy. You ain't heard it neither, is you?
No, what is the lineup?
I figured on having her open with Beethoven's Fifth Symphony.
Yeah, well, that sounds good. Everybody knows that, anyway.
The only thing is, fellas, symphonies don't have no words to them.
Don't, huh? Well, we'll have it a hum the first number, yeah. after she comes out with that, then she comes out and she smacks him with the Flight of the Bumblebee.
Is that one got words or has she got a buzzer?
Oh, look, fella. Quiet, Emma.
Yeah, keep still.
Then we got a short intermission when we sell Cracker Jack, soft drinks, postcards, and all that. After that, Madam Queen come out in the semi-wind-up with Indian Love Call, and then for the main event, she ups and slaps him with the Waters of Minnesota. All we got. tell me this, how do it sound, Andy?
Well, tell you the truth, Kingfish, I don't exactly know.
Tell you the truth, Andy, I don't know myself.
You see, fellas, it even sounds silly to you. Now, there's a couple of things we all know. Madam Queen has got a good voice, and if she went with Mr. John Charles Thomas, why, she might have a big future ahead of her. You fellas really wouldn't want to spoil that future, would you?
What you think, Kingfish?
I think I'm thinking just what you're thinking.
Then must we do it?
Yeah.
Oh, fellas, I know you'd do the right thing and tear up that contract. Now Madam Queen can go into Carnegie Hall.
Only one thing I was a little sad about and giving this whole music thing up. I was kind of getting to like being a music lover.
Yes, and I was getting to like being part of the music world, too. Well, maybe there's still room for us to get in it somewhere.
Yeah, I sure wish we could stay close to music some way.
Me too, Brother Andrew. For the rest of my life, the nearer the music I is, the happier I'd be. Carnegie Hall. How wonderful. Can't we figure out something?
Ladies and gentlemen, as a finale to our Stars of Tomorrow concert, here in Carnegie Hall, we are asking our featured artist, Madam Queen, to oblige us with a very short encore of the number you just enjoyed so much.
Lindy Lou, Lindy Lou. Right down and die. If I could sing like that bird sings to you, my little Lindy Lou, my Lindy.
Gentlemen, we've brought you here at Carnegie Hall tonight many new artists whom we feel have the touch of greatness. It is the hope of the Wilson Foundation that you will be able to enjoy them for many, many years to come. Thank you for your support.
Well, Jerry, I thought it was really a wonderful concert. I'm certainly glad you got those tickets.
Me too. They certainly had a big crowd here.
Yeah.
Come on, let's hurry up the aisle and get out before the rush.
Okay. Say, that last singer, that Madam Queen, she was terrific, wasn't she?
Yeah, she'll go places all right.
You bet. Say, how about having a bite to eat, huh?
It's a good idea. I just want to go in the men's lounge here and wash up.
Righto, I'll wait here for you.
towel, sir?
And here's a clean comb for you, sir.
You know, Kingfish, it's great to be a part of the music world.
Be sure to be with us again next Friday evening at this same time when Amos and Andy will have as their guest Mr. Sidney Greenstreet. Our thanks to John Charles Thomas for appearing with us tonight. Mr. Thomas is the star of the Westinghouse Sunday program and appears with Amos and Andy through the courtesy of the Westinghouse Company. The Amos and Andy Show is broadcast to our armed forces everywhere. This is Harlow Wilcox bidding you all a very pleasant good night. And when you get Rinso tomorrow, buy some Lifebuoy, too. Use Lifebuoy in your daily bath or shower. You love that rich, purifying lather. You know, of seven leading brands, Lifebuoy gives you the most soap for your money. And besides, it's the only soap specially made to stop
B.O.
This is the National Broadcasting Company.